So this is a little bit trickier. To answer this one, we have to look at the code after the procedure. And remember, we said the procedure is replacing these four lines. After the procedure, what we do is print the value of URL. So that means we definitely need at least URL as our output. And all of the choices here included URL. But that's not all we do. So we have to look at the second line as well. Well, this uses both page and end quote. The value of page here is the same as the value of page before the procedure. So we don't actually need to return the value of page. It doesn't need to be an output from the procedure because we already know that. We knew that before we called the procedure. The procedure doesn't change the value of page. No sense making it an output. So this answer doesn't make sense. We don't need page. It does make sense to make end quote one of the outputs. And the reason we want end quote as an output is we need to know where the end of the quote was to advance the page. So the next time we look for the next target, we don't find the same one that we just found. So we actually need this. So this is the best answer to this question, is that we need two outputs. We need both the URL and the value of end quote. The fourth possibility could work. So if we return both the URL and the value of start link, well, we could figure out a way to advance the page to not find the same quote, but we'd basically have to redo all this code. We need to look for the next quote starting from start link. We need to look for the closing quote for that. Basically, we need to compute the value of end quote again. So it's a lot more useful to return the value of end quote than to return the value of start link. That's why the third choice is the best choice.